Welcome back to another live with Design Bundles. We are so excited to have you back here. I hope you guys all had a Merry Christmas, if you will, and a happy holiday. So today's project, we are going to be working with Dollar Tree mugs. This is a highly requested one. We get questions about this all of the time. So I'm going to walk you guys all the way through the project of adding our designs inside of Cricut Design Space, cutting them out, weeding them out, and applying them to the mug. So I've got a couple of the Dollar Tree mugs here. There's a few different sizes and shapes and colors you guys can snag, but you guys can create a very quick gift for a buck. So a few things. We are now on our 8th live. Thank you guys so much for supporting us. We are excited to be live with you guys. We love chatting with you. So we've actually unlocked a feature now to where we can do super chats and super stickers. So we're going to come up with some really fun and cool stuff for those. So whenever you guys do those, we're going to keep your name up longer and be able to answer those questions for you. Now that we're getting a lot more people hanging out with us, those things are obviously, we had a ton of questions last time, and we want to make sure that we're able to answer everybody. Now, also, if you guys have noticed, we are doing the Christmas Plus event, and we are getting down to our last few days. So December 31st will be our last day for the Plus Christmas event. So I hope you guys are snagging all of your free goodies. All right, so let's go ahead and dive right in. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and share my screen with you guys. So welcome, 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 everybody that is joining us. Thank you guys so much for joining us. We're so excited for this. Now, for the designs that I'm using today, they are from the Amazing Craft Bundle. This bundle is only $24. It was originally $306. So you're getting $306 worth of SVGs, PNGs, $24. So I'm going to go ahead and show you guys what all's included here. There's lots of different files here for you, whether you guys are going to be making some mom, you know, the messy buns. We've got some stuff for Valentine's Day. We have stickers, earrings, lots of different ones. So I'm going to show you a few of the ones I'm using today. So for example, this one right here, super duper adorable. You have all these cows here. And I wanted to show you guys a few different things. Whether you guys are going to be using cute little quotes or whether you want to use something like this cow head, it's kind of like a silhouette, if you will, and it is gorgeous. So we're going to use this one right here out of this bundle. And then say, for example, right here, these dog quotes, not only are they perfect for t-shirts, pillows, mugs, keychains, you know, you can put them on tote bags, all sorts of different things. So I want to show you one of these on our mug. So a lot of times we have different photos here. You can kind of scroll through here and get an idea of what all's included in there. Now I've got one more here if I can find it. There was a cute little coffee cup. Let's see. It's somewhere in here. But it's the other one that I'm going to be using today. But one of the ones I wanted to show you too, I almost made for you guys. Look at this amazing basketball bundle here as well. I think this is super cute. And what's really cool is you're going to use not only black, you're going to use your orange as well. You could use like an orange glitter. Adhesive vinyl would be gorgeous as well, but such a cute one. And I do believe there is one for football as well. So there's this one right up here. So we have mascot, but I do believe there was a super cute football one right up here. So this would be cute on t-shirts, mugs, same with the other one, the SVGs. You can turn those into PNGs and sublimate with them as well. So these are super, super cute. Also, so let me go see if I can find, if not, we're just going to go ahead and go over there. But I believe there was a coffee cup one that specifically said there's motivational. I know I'm overlooking it in here. So let me see, we're almost there, winter, it's in here somewhere. So I'm going to go ahead and we're going to drop the screen really quick so I can show you guys what supplies that we are using today. So let me go ahead and switch my camera down here really quick. All right, so for our supplies today, it's going to be super duper easy. Hello, hello, hello. Welcome everybody that is here. Welcome, welcome. Hello from Florida. I see all of you guys, Palm Coast, Florida. Lots of you guys from Florida today. Jody, we have you from Missouri, Pacific Northwest. Welcome, welcome. So if you guys are just joining us, we are going to be doing some DIY coffee mugs. We are going to be using our Cricut Explorer 3. You could use any of your die cutting machines for this project. Even your Cricut Joy is perfect for making mugs. So we've got our coffee mugs from the Dollar Tree. We have some transfer tape. And then what I'm using today, I'm using my blue mat. I love to use this for adhesive vinyl. And the one I'm using today is matte black, but it is permanent and it is StarCraft. I love StarCraft. I'm a huge fan of it right now. If I wasn't using StarCraft, I like Oracle 651. So between Oracle 651 and StarCraft, those are my absolute favorite when it comes to making mugs. I'm going to go ahead and smooth this guy down right here. And I'm going to show you guys just a few more things. So give me just a minute because I'm going to get ready for sharing my screen. So just give me a second. As you guys are joining in here, welcome, welcome, welcome. Thank you guys so much for joining. Now, a few more things that I'm using today is a ruler. I highly recommend if you guys do not have one of these are in the sewing section. You could usually grab them for a buck. A lot of times, even at the fair, if you guys go to like the state fairs, some people are carrying these as well. They're perfect because you're able to just, these are, like I said, sewing department to whip it out to figure out the measurement for our mug. So before we do get started, I want to measure those. But a few more things we need is a squeegee tool. You can also use your hands. And then I've got a couple of weeding tools here. So let's go ahead and get our measurement really quick. So when we're working with mugs, the first thing that you want to figure out is whether you're making this for yourself or for a friend. Which hand do you hold your mug in when you drink your coffee or tea? If I hold it in the right hand, I want this side to be the front. If I hold it in my left, I would want this side to be in the front. So if you're selling these on Etsy or places like that, you definitely want to find out what side do they use, the right or the left hand. So I'm going to go ahead. Let's see. I think I'm going to go ahead and put mine on this side right here. So a few more things that you're going to need, rubbing alcohol and a clean cloth, but also sometimes I just get rid of the rubbing alcohol and I just use the cloth, and that's okay too. So what I do is I get these eyeglass cloths here and I use those to remove any sort of oil or debris. Now, if you guys have not seen this video, I actually sublimated these. We have a video here on the channel. You can look up sublimation eyeglass cloth, I believe. And we made this right here on the channel and I use it all the time. All right, so let's go ahead and measure really quick and then we'll switch on over to Cricut Design Space. So we're going to go and get our measurement here. So I know that I don't want to go no wider than 4 inches. So I probably really want to stick with like 3.75 wide. So no wider than 4 inches. And then my height here, I'll go ahead and get this up at the top. I don't want to drag it all the way to the bottom. So I don't want to go, you know, I've got 4 inches here, same thing. I probably don't want to go bigger by 3.75. So I'm going to try to design this 3.75 by 3.75. Hello, hello. Welcome, everybody. All right. So let me go ahead and switch you guys over to Cricut Design Space really quick. All right. So let me switch my camera so you guys can see my face at the same time. All right. So here we go. Now I have already brought in my designs here. So these are going to be the three that I'm using today. So this is all from that bundle, but this is from the dog one. This one here, there is a coffee cup one. There is one for coffee quotes. I got this out of there. And then you guys see that super cute cow. So the first thing I want to do is resize these. So I'm going to go ahead and come in here, click on them. And then right at the top, I'm going to change the height because you can see my width is 4.73 and my height is 5.74. I want to go with my height because that's the bigger one. So I'm going to go ahead and change it now to 3.75. 3.75. Now make sure if you guys have any questions, leave them down below and we'll be answering those while I'm cutting out as well as weeding everything. So let's go ahead and change this one. This one's pretty even. So I'll find the bigger one, the 5.7. I'm going to do 3.75. Enter. And then we've got one more of the screen right here. We're going to do the same thing. I'm going to change the screen, this file. 3.75. There we go. All right. So this is going to be I'm trying to think here if I want this a little bit smaller and bigger. I think this is fine. All right. So I'm going to roll with these three here. So I wanted to show you, if I click on these individual, they do have different little pieces. Since I'm cutting this all out in black, what I would do right away is come down to weld and I would weld it. So now if I click on it, it's one file. So you see how that went over to one solid file? So this one's ready to go. Next one, this one right here. If I wanted to, say for example, to come in here, I want to get rid of these two little swoop marks. I could click on them and just hit delete on my keyboard. And then I would just have this design here. Say for example, if I wanted to change any of these, like my coffee beans, if I wanted to come up here and change those to brown, I could. I would come click on the right-hand side. I would click on those beans, come over here, click on the colored square and change it to brown. So you see how that changed there? So I could definitely do that. I'm gonna leave everything black. We're cutting everything out matte black today. But if I wanted to, any of these pieces here, I could change colors. So I could change this to pink. So that is how you would change those individually. So I am going to do the same thing. I'm gonna select everything and I'm gonna hit weld to make it one solid file. So you guys see how that became one solid file. And we've got one more. So same thing with this one. If I wanted to change any of these pieces, say for example, my dog, I wanted to come in here and change it to purple, or if I was cutting out a pattern or anything like that, I could also do that. So I'm gonna keep these, select everything, and I'm gonna hit weld. Now, this is not HDV iron-on, it's adhesive vinyl, so we don't need to mirror anything. So I'm gonna go ahead and hit make it. So before you hit make it, make sure that you guys have chose the proper machine. So say, for example, if I was using the Maker 3 or the Joy, you'd go ahead and choose that here if you need to. Mine's already set on the correct machine. So we're going to hit make it and we're going to get ready to send this on over. Now today I am using the StarCraft material and then I've already got, let's see here, I'm going to go ahead and say on the mat. And then I'm going to hit done. So I'm using my mat today because I'm not using any smart material. So what I need to do is I'm actually going to hit cancel. You notice how this, I can do two things. This came onto a separate mat because I didn't change the color. This has to be like a little bit of a lighter black. And so what I could do is either go back, change the color, or simply I can click on these three dots right here. I can say move object, and then we can click on our other mat, click confirm. And then I can line these up. So I'm going to go ahead and grab it and scoot it on over. Now I like to give myself just a little bit of gap in between my designs so that way I have room to cut with and everything. So everything's ready to go. Once again, I do not need to mirror anything because this is just adhesive vinyl. So easy peasy, we're going to hit continue. And then we are going to choose our materials. So give me just a second. We're just loading our machine here. And then here we go. So I'm going to choose for this one, permanent vinyl glossy. If it's not popping up on your favorites, you can just simply come to browse all material and you can just start to type out either permanent or vinyl. So if I type out vinyl, just like this, enter, I'm going to get all these different types of vinyls to choose from. So I'm going to go ahead and actually use premium vinyl removable. Well, it's not removable. I'm going to do the permanent glossy. That's what I always just choose, even though it's matte, that's what I choose. And then we're ready to go. So let's go ahead and get ready to load this. I'm gonna go ahead and switch my camera really quickly here. So that way you guys can see me load this right in. All right, so let's go ahead. I've already loaded this on the mat. So all I need to do is slide this under these 2 feet, hit the load button, and then it's gonna go ahead and load it inside really quickly. Oh, I did something. Hold on. Try it again. I must have had, it's like it's hitting something at the back. Give it just a second. Okay. I'm not sure what I did, but it's taking it now. I think what may have happened is my power cord, see my fingers, my power cord, I think was kind of turned up like this and it was hitting the back. All right. So it's loaded everything. Everything is good to go. I'm going to double check everything's down and I'm going to hit go. So once that flashing button, the go button starts to flash, we're ready to go. So I'm hoping this is going to, something just seems off with it right now. Maybe everything's okay. Just give me 1 second. I'm just eyeballing it to make sure. Because when you're live, that's when everything wants to mess up. All right. So let me go ahead and switch you guys up here really quick. And let's get ready to answer any sort of questions that you guys might have while it's cutting out. Hopefully you guys can see that there in the background. Let's see. Will the mugs be dishwasher safe or do you suggest hand washing? Whenever it comes to adhesive vinyl, hand wash. And whenever we say hand wash, it doesn't mean like just kind of soak it down in your sink of water. What hand washing is, you want to kind of dip it down, get your rag, lightly clean, rinse it out. Because if you let it soak in that water, you can let that adhesive start to get... you know, the water and all that's going to go underneath the adhesive and it can remove, but it lasts a long time if you hand wash it, but if you dishwash it, it will start to take those off over time. But I am working on a video. You guys should see it over the next month, I think, or so. I did a versus video, sublimation versus adhesive vinyl, to show the pros and cons. All right. Is there any more questions? Can you change the words in the designs? Yes, you can. Once this is done, I'll kind of show you guys that briefly as well. So what you can actually do is get rid of those. You can't actually, I don't think you can actually edit that text, but I could just delete that piece out, bring in my own text, and definitely switch that out as well. All right, let's see. Is there anything else? Dollar Bundle event is Wednesday. Yes, it is. So we do have the dollar event coming up. So that is Wednesday, and we will be going live. So I'm going to craft some of, I'm already going to have some pre-made items, and I'm going to craft some with you guys. So that way I can show you guys messing around with some of these dollar deals files and things. So Wednesday, but we actually come in at 11 Central Standard Time. So make sure you guys hit that notification. You guys should see that come up this afternoon. Hit that bell so you guys can see whenever it's ready. Or you can definitely check back closer to that 11. So we go live on Mondays at 2 p.m. Central Standard Time and 11 for the dollar deal. So I'm so pumped about that dollar deal. Is there something we can use to seal it to last longer? Yes, you can. You can actually use a dishwasher safe. I always say it wrong, but it's Mod Podge. And that will actually help seal it up and last a lot longer as well. So you could just kind of go over that with it to help ensure that it'll last longer. But they truly will. Like I did a dishwasher test one time. I did Oracle against Cricut, I do believe. And they've went through, I'm sure it'll last maybe one wash if you accidentally threw it in the wash. I've done that before too, but you are running the risk. But if you just simply, it can last a long time. I have a wine glass that has our Arkansas State on it. I've had for several years now. So they can last a long time. Is okay. I've already answered that one. Can you do a video using the mug press? Yes. And we actually have several videos here on the channel, but stay tuned because we will be doing some of those live as well. But we do have lots of those here on the channel, and I've got lots more coming up. Let's see, if you want to add text, is there any way to see what the font was used for matching? At this moment, sometimes in those files, there's a text me, and sometimes they do show that. I'll have to kind of go through there. Sometimes, you know, Cricut's a little finicky. Sometimes there's a text me file. I'll show that to you guys soon, and it'll show you what font was used. So I'll try to show you guys that real soon. All right, let's see. Will you be making any Valentine's? Yes, we do. We are already working on some Valentine projects, and we'll also be working on some live. We've got a really cool one coming up, so stay tuned. Let's see. Anything else? Any other questions? Thank you guys so much for joining us today. We are so excited. Every time you guys join us live, it is just a ton of fun. It's really nice to do these live because I can interact with you guys and hang out and answer those questions right away so you guys kind of know. So it really helps because I'm able to even show you guys or demo things as well. So I think what is taking the longest is probably those pieces from the cow, maybe. I'm really just hoping everything is going smooth because when you go live, there's really no telling which way this could go, right or left. So now one thing I am working on too is sublimation with these Dollar Tree mugs while we're waiting for this. I am wanting to do a video on sublimating these. There is not a special coating on these. So that's a question we get all the time. Can you sublimate these? And the answer is no as of right now because there's not a special coating on it. But I am working on, there is a poly coating that you can put on these. I believe there's even a spray one I want to get and try out. I'm just trying to get it in the mug press because this will probably work best in the cone-shaped one. It's definitely not going to work in the Cricut mug press because of that shape here. But I am working on showing you guys a hack for that. But really, honestly, that's a question we get a lot with sublimation is the Cricut mugs truly or any other mugs, if you look at the price, they're really about $1 or $2 each. They're not really bad. So I think it's just having them accessible, but Cricut does have them in store. Do you ever put the mugs in the oven to cure the vinyl? I have not. I probably wouldn't just because the vinyl could melt. I'm not sure if at a low temp, but what I actually do to cure these, which I was going to talk about at the end, is you definitely want to let them sit aside for 48 to 72 hours. So if you let these set, they will cure. So if you try to wash them right away, it could come off. So 48 to 72 hours, that adhesive really will bond to that mug. So that's all you need, 42 to 72 hours. So let me go ahead and unload this really quick. All right, it went smoothly. I just had a feeling. Okay, so we've got all of our pieces here. So let me go ahead and drop you guys down really quick so we can remove this from the mat. And what I usually like to do is flip the mat over and then peel like this. There we go. set this out of our way. All right, let's get all of our pieces here. Could I get 37 cents change? Thank you so much, Miley, for your super chat. I am so excited. All right, so here we go. So I've got, if you guys remember our live last time, I used this piece right here and I just placed it right back on top, and that's what we're going to use today. So if you guys missed it, this is a piece I used and I just rolled it right back on here. So we're going to use this today. So let's go ahead and get ready to weed this out. So we are going to go ahead and weed. So if you guys have any questions while I'm weeding this, I'll try to answer those. Or if you guys want to chat, we'll definitely do so. So you guys let me know, what did you get for Christmas? Did anybody get any Cricut machines? Did anybody get any mug presses, sublimation printers, anything crafty? I want to know. Drop it down below. I'm so excited. Let's see. Your blue mat is really sticky. Now, the reason why is because the last time I used it on I used it on a paper craft project, and I kind of used my scraper to scrape it off. And I think the way that it, I don't know how to explain it, the adhesive, it's a little bit stickier this time. All right, so what I'm going to use is my little pin weeding tool here. Happy birthday, happy birthday, happy birthday. All right, let's see. I'm going to go ahead and start to weed these guys out. Now, the StarCraft stuff is amazing. I love it. And you guys are going to see me weeding out this small font. I think it's super perfect for small font. It's fantastic. Now, I will say when it comes to these mugs, be mindful for super sublimation printer and bright pad Epson printer. Yay! That is amazing. I'm so excited. I printed for sublimation. Can't wait to get started. Oh, you're going to have to check out our videos. Especially for 2022, I've got some sublimation stuff coming up, guys, for the Epson as well. So stay tuned. Got the Maker 3 bundle. Yay! How exciting! I'm so excited for you guys. Bought my first mug press for Christmas. Congratulations. I cannot wait to see all of your projects. Make sure you guys are using the hashtag design bundles or hashtag design bundles live if you are recreating our live projects, because we definitely want to see all of your projects. Let's see. Also, we are doing a giveaway. I almost forgot to tell you guys that. We are doing a giveaway at the end of this live. If you guys are live, you guys are going to have a chance to win. So use the hashtag bundles to win the bundle that I'm using today. So the bundle that I showed you guys at the beginning, you guys are going to have a chance to win the entire bundle. So make sure you use hashtag bundle for a chance to win. So super, super excited. Got a sublimation printer. The weed is great. Yes, this is so, so easy. I'm telling you, the StarCraft, if you guys have not tried it out, highly recommend. So we're just going to go ahead and continue to weed all of these pieces out here. Just like so. I think I got two of my mugs bumping over here. So they're like, ding, 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 ding. Let's see. I'm so glad to be on the live today. Yay. Thank you so much. Let's see. You got things. Let's see. Hold on one second. Just starting out with the crafting, have most of my things, press and printer, just a little nervous. Oh, do not be nervous. You are going to do great. I know you are. All right, I want to show you guys something really quick. I lost an A and an S. Remember how last time I talked about sticking this on the table? Don't ever just kind of crumble this. Set it on the table. So if you guys didn't join us last, take this corner right here and pop it on the corner of your table, on the side of your table. That way, in case you lose something, you can go back for it. So I need to come back for this A. And I have an S, so bear with me for just a second. The best one I like using for that is this. Also, if you guys are curious, I'm using a pin. It has a needle in it, and I do like to use it for my little pieces, the little intricate tiny pieces. I like it for that. All right. I think I got a few pieces off of my coffee bean too, so just bear with me for a second. I go back and snag these. Let's see, got me a sublimation printer and clamshell press. Congratulations, Lori. I'm so excited. That is so, so sweet of them to do that. I'm telling you guys, this is the, I love seeing what all you guys get for Christmas, because I really think that's the time that we stock up on our craft stuff. I also like for myself, because that's when you can get good deals as well. For example, like sublimate, like your sawgrass printer, usually the ink goes 20% off and things. So I really like to stock up. Does anybody else like to stock up on blanks or craft supplies, especially like Michael's? I love to go in there and stock up as well. One more piece here. Sticking it to the, yes, his favorite trick. Yay, I'm so excited, Christina. So I'm telling you, because it's definitely worth it, because you see I had to go back for a couple pieces. I think I'm also missing an eye. I lost a lot of pieces today. I got a little crazy. So let's see. Let me go back for one more piece here. There we go. I think that was my last one. I'm going to double check everything really quick. So we've got one more. Oh, by the way, guys, if you guys joined us last live, did you see where I put my my letter upside down? I know that all of you guys were screaming at me to flip it back around. And I, as soon as we got off the live, I flipped it around. So if you guys were watching that cookie, trust me, I realized as soon as we got off. Okay, so let me see here. Remember to use that hashtag bundles for a chance to win at the very end. We're going to do a giveaway using the entire bundle here. So I'm super excited for one of you lucky winners to be crafting, and you'll be able to craft with it ASAP. So whoever wins, it's so nice because you just simply shoot them an email and they will send you over that file ASAP, and you could be crafting with it within seconds. So they are pretty quick at getting that done for us. So let's see here. Missing the G is in a, let's see, hold on one second, in adulting. Hey, now, see, there you go. Thank you so much. Thank you. You saved me. See, and I was listening this time. Adulting. You know what? The whole thing, I think, because I welded it. Nobody pay attention. I welded it and I lost it during welding. So let me go back and look really quickly. That's one thing that you guys want to make sure you pay attention to. Hold on one second here. Yes. Let's see if we can switch you guys back up to my screen here really fast. I want to show you what I did. So when I went to weld this, this happens sometimes. You see right here, now I'm missing the G. So while I do this mug, ignore me, pretend it's not there. Sometimes when we do this, so let's go ahead and hit the undo button. And I'm going to do it one more time because I welded this one. Let's see. Okay, one more time. One more time. It should undo this one. Give me 2 seconds while I'm undoing. I think I'll have to undo it one more time. There we go. See how that G popped right back in there? Sometimes when we weld these, select everything, I'm going to hit weld. It's so close that it just disappears. So make sure that you guys are super duper careful. So what I would actually do instead of welding, I would hit undo. I would select everything and I would just hit attach. So you don't always have to hit weld. So you could just simply hit attach. I like to hit weld because see how it still stays as like multiple pieces. Whereas when I hit weld, it came one. So I would definitely hit attach on this file if you guys are going to use it, because that can happen. And this is not the only one. It's just Cricut. Sometimes that happens and it likes to do that. Okay, so we could go ahead and switch us back down here and we will finish weeding all of these pieces out. So thank you so much for noticing that for me. You guys saved me. So that's what I love about this. Let's see. Add the apostrophe and it's Southern. That's right. I love that. I love it. Adulting. I love it. So cute. So being Southern, it just fixes everything. All right. So I think for this one here, I'm trying to, let me eyeball. I think one of the things is too, if you guys got a bright pad, I do love that for weeding. It does really help. I'm just kind of lazy sometimes. Also, another piece that went away is this coffee bean. So I lost some of my pieces in the coffee bean. So those are lessons to be learned today. The differences between welding and attaching. Sometimes it's better to attach because it's going to all cut in one spot still. It's just going to avoid, you know, messing any pieces up. So let me grab my last two little pieces and then we'll quickly weed out our cow and we'll pop these together. All right, let's see. I can't stand when those pesky letters disappear. I'm telling you what, it really stinks, especially when you go through this entire project and then you notice that you're missing those pieces, or you gift it to somebody and then they say something and it's like you didn't even notice. I've done that too, or have stuff upside down or reversed and I don't even notice, and then somebody else points it out. These ones right here with this cow is my absolute favorite to weed out because they're so much fun. Let me go ahead and get in here. It's almost like a puzzle. It reminds me, I guess, like a mandala or something, and popping them out and seeing them come to life, it's just gorgeous. So just coming in here and popping all these pieces, and you can slowly start to see my cow pop in here. These are my favorite, even just to sit down and weed these like a puzzle for fun is just so much fun. Love, love, love. So I'm going to go ahead and weed this piece here. But as you guys can see with the StarCraft, it's amazing. It weeds like a dream. So I'm just going to go ahead and with this pin, this little tiny needle really helps for these little bitty pieces here. Go in here and get this. Sometimes I can't multitask and talk at the same time. So bear with me while I get these little bitty pieces. But while I'm doing this, once again, I need that weeder. It's awesome. So it has like a little bitty pin in here. And we get this from 143 Movement. I already have it linked down below for you guys. It's one of our favorites to use here. We use this as well as just the Cricut weeder like this. I work between the two. But for teensy pieces, and it definitely is a learning curve. So whenever you first start weeding with one like this, what I do is I don't go straight down. I kind of have to go at an angle and then poke it and then pop up. And also with teensy pieces, you can, it's, you know, sticky because I just popped one off. I can stick that onto another one and it'll pick it up. And I'll keep doing that over and over and over again and then kind of pick it off, if that makes sense. It just kind of helps grab onto itself and pick another one up when you're in like a little tight area. So I love it. That. So let's see, hashtag bundles, got a maker for Christmas. Yay. Let's see, if you just bump it out a couple of decimal fractions, sometimes it'll correct. Yes. So that's another thing that you could do. You could definitely just ungroup that little set of words there. And you could definitely just bump it over. And that's what I do with font. So whenever, for example, if I type out Samantha, and if I go to weld it all together as one and I lose it, I'll do exactly what she just said, is I'll start to bump it over just a teensy tiny bit until it fixes. So yes, that is 100% true. You can also do that as well. And like I said, it's more of preference whether you weld or attach at that point, because basically I'm just making one file. I don't have to do that. And attaching does fix it as well. Like I said, it's just kind of preference of which one you like to use more. I'm prone to hitting weld more than attach. Let's go ahead and see if I can snag this little guy out. What it's wanting to do is pick up on my pieces, and I don't want to do that. So whenever I get to little pieces like this, it kind of, I hate when they want to try to pick up on themselves, because you can sometimes tear them or distort them. So I'm trying to be super duper careful. There we go. Yeah, sometimes these little guys like this want to distort and get a little crazy. And these little pieces, I don't really like to get this intricate for coffee mugs because they are more prone. There's not a lot of adhesive left to hold onto your mug. So that's something to keep in mind, as well as, like I said, working with teensy, teensy, tiny little font, because those are going to be more prone to fall off. So definitely keep that in mind. So I'm going to go ahead and keep on weeding these little pieces. Make sure you guys are using that hashtag bundles. Also, if you guys have any questions or anything, definitely drop them down below. We will be doing Q&A at the end in case there is any extra questions. Once again, we did get to open up the super chat, so we are so excited about that feature, as well as the super stickers. So as we're trekking along, I can't even speak today. I think this holiday has me so messed up. So as we are trekking through this lives, we are earning new things, and we're so excited about our new features. No problem. If it keeps doing it in groups, the letter, you can manually move it over. Yes, you can. You can definitely manually just move it over and bump it over. So I can definitely tell you guys have learned a few things along the way. That's how I am. You know, you just kind of, once you're playing with it quite a bit, you just kind of learn what works best. And the easiest, because that stuff will happen right there inside of Cricut Design Space. All right, so I think I have all of my pieces. Check out how cute this cow is. How adorable is this? Now, there were several in this folder, if you guys remember, on this file. There were several of these little guys, but I think this would be so, so cute to add somebody's name. So say, for example, when we pop this on the mug in a second, I think it would be so cute to add somebody's name on the back or somebody's monogram, or even right here to be like mom life or something, I think would be gorgeous. So I wanted to show you a mixture, like I said, of these. So let's go ahead and get ready to pick them up. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to try to use the same transfer tape a couple of times. So let's go ahead and trim this down just a little bit. And let's see here. You guys let me know down below, have you guys made any Dollar Tree mugs? And what's your favorite kind of mugs to make? Do you guys like making them like this, or do you like to do fonts? Let's say quotes or silhouettes. Would you rather do a silhouette or a quote? So I want to start off with my super cute cow, because I'm just moving on with this little fella. It's so cute. All right, so the next step is what we have to do. Once again, I take the corner of this and I just pop it on the corner of my table. And now that I'm done with this, I stuck my pieces of the extras right here. Now I can go ahead and get this ready to throw away. And I could see how I was able to go back. So here we go. So what we're going to need here is we're going to take our cloth. I've got some rubbing alcohol in one of these little spray bottles. This is actually a Tim Holtz spray bottle. You could get these on Amazon. Hi, Joy. Welcome this morning. Loving the bundles. Hopefully, I'll be able to get it before it expires. Yes, Joy. This is an amazing bundle, or maybe you will win it today. So, Joy, make sure you use that hashtag bundle. Started with Dollar Tree, now Mug Press. Are you loving that Cricut Mug Press? I love it so much. Or do you have a regular Mug Press? All right, so for the alcohol, you could just put it in one of these spritzer bottles. It makes it so much easier because then you're able to just kind of spritz it like this. Now, I also seen from the Dollar Tree, there is like a little pump up thing. So you can like hit that pump up and then rub it just like so. Now, like I said, I don't always use rubbing alcohol. I just use this little cloth like so. Now, these little eyeglass cloths come with lots of things like your new screens for your phones, etc. And I throw them all in my craft space. All right, so there we go. Just like that. So what I'm going to do, these right here, these squeegee tools are my favorite right now because of these two lines. So these two lines really help my mug stay still so I can pop them on just like this and really get them nice and straight. So sometimes I'll even take, like, for example, this right here, my little, just to kind of hold that handle up. Lots of different ways to do this. But if you guys have not snagged one of these little scrapers with the centers here, you could just do this. Hold its center for you, right? And then we'll come back to it when we need it, but we need it right now. So move that out of the way. So I usually keep two of these on hand. I just didn't have a second one in the studio here today. Coffee filters work great. So yes, those do work great as well for cleaning your mugs. Great tip there. So usually I have two of these on hand. So what I need to do here is pick up our little guy. So I've got my piece of transfer tape. I'm going to go down now from the Dollar Tree. If you wanted to do all of this from the Dollar Tree, they do now carry vinyl, and they also carry the clear contact paper, which is for your shelves to line your shelves and drawers. You can use that as well. So you could get everything from the Dollar Tree. They even have weeding tools that look like Cricut weeding tools. They have everything. So we are going to go ahead and do this. I cut noodles and tape together using a cup holder. Yes, I have one like that too. One of the subscribers one time had made me one with, I believe it's like plumbing pipes and pool noodles. And it's so awesome. I use that sometimes too, but I get a lot of questions on where to get it from. And I'm like, I can't get it for you because somebody made it for me as a gift. It was so sweet. I got mine from Amazon. They are blue. I love Amazon. All right. So I'm going to go ahead and rub this in just like so. All right, so we're just going to go ahead and rub it like that. So what we're going to do, the best way to peel this is flip it upside down, peel it a corner, just like this. There we go. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring back in that squeegee like I was talking about, just like this. And then we're going to line this up like that. And then now what we're going to do is I'm going to hover over this. So I'm just going to try to hover over the center of this. I can't see because I'm using my cameras. And what I'm doing is I'm going to go down like a taco. So I start from the center and roll outwards, just like so. So then what I'll do is I'll rub my finger in the middle and then rub one side and rub the next. It just makes it so easy, easy peasy. So you could definitely just rub this with your fingers if you wanted to, just like this. Or you could come back in with that squeegee and really press that in to get it to bond, just like that. And then the best way to remove this is getting it out of corner here and, oh, I love the matte colors. I'm obsessed with the matte. Once I started using matte vinyl, and you have to get in permanent because there's permanent and removable, I'm hooked. That's my favorite. I think they just look gorgeous. You don't have all that glare on them from the glossy, but look how cute this is. Is this not cute? So something as simple as this, it doesn't always have to be a quote. It could be a silhouette like this, lots of different ones. And as you guys seen in that bundle, there was football ones, there was basketball ones, lots of different ones. And if you guys want a chance to win it today, use that hashtag bundles for a chance to win. We're going to draw a winner today. You have to be live to be watching for a chance to win. So there you guys have it. So, so cute. All right. So we're going to pop that out of our way and let's go ahead and bring in another one. So I'm going to use that same transfer. Actually, I'm using this other one because it's a little bit bigger. I'm going to do this coffee one next. So I'm going to go ahead and go down like a taco once again. Thank you so much, Cheryl. So I'm going to go ahead and do the same thing. Go ahead and rub this down. So this is going to show using a quote. And you guys can see I stayed within that 3.75. So this is going to be 3.75 wide instead of high. And then this one's going to be the height. So you guys get a little bit of different dimensions. And you guys can see right there inside of Cricut Design Space, I got rid of those little garnishes. What do you call them? Those little things. Thank you so much, Joy. So, you know, those little whoop-de-woos that I got rid of that was on top of this coffee, you're able to get rid of those pieces. If I wanted to get rid of my coffee beans, I could get rid of the coffee beans. So I love that. Also, you know, just like if we have like a die cutting, you know, the little, we would press them with a little die cutting machine and stuff, we could keep these little coffee beans and we can use them with another file. Lots of different things that you guys could do. Same thing with this. If I wanted to use just this dog out of this file, I could just use that dog. So lots of different things to think about when you're doing these and using these SVGs. All right, so we're gonna flip it over once again. We are going to remove it. We got a little guy trying to follow us, a couple of them. And with this one, as you guys can see, if you guys caught my last live, you guys can see how much easier this is going. So that Cricut Smart Vinyl, that backing is super thick. So the backing from StarCraft and regular, even the regular Cricut, not the Smart, their backing is crumbly, right? It's super duper soft. Where Smart Vinyl, it is so thick, and that's what makes it so hard to peel off unless you're using the Cricut brand transfer tape. So here's our super cute file. So let's go ahead and get our next one. We're gonna clean it again. Once again, using a sprayer makes it so easy. You could get the dollar sprayers at Walmart, wherever. Dollar Tree has sprayers. Happy I caught you live. I'm so excited that you are here, Roberta. So we're gonna go ahead and rub this down just like so, cleaning it up. Once again, same thing. Get this in here just like this, and we're good to go. Another thing I want to point out, I'm always talking about saving stuff. Like I talk about these, you know, you get them whenever you put your the glass on your phones. I even had one that came with a spritzer bottle, the really skinny ones. So instead of tossing that out, I think it even has rubbing alcohol. I could keep filling it. So those are things to think about as well. All right. So same thing. Whenever it comes to a quote, I'm going to center it up. Once again, I'm using my camera, so I'm not sure if I'm even straight. I'm going to go down like a taco. So you can see I've got my center down. I'm going to go down like this. So nothing's even like all the way down yet. I'm going to go in that center first, rubbing my finger down, and then I'm going to rub one way. And then I'll go back and I'll get the other side. I think I buckled my D just a little bit, but that's okay. So I'm just going to do it just like that. So coming down like a taco with that center, rubbing the center. Remember to ignore this. Let's pretend that there's a G there. So we're gonna go ahead and just rub all of this out. Now, what you could do is what I've done a billion times, I'll go back, you know, and I would actually get rid of, and I would contour, delete all these pieces out and keep the G, quickly cut it out, pop it back on, call it a day. So that's how I would fix that. So I'm gonna go ahead and rub these down. Go ahead and take our little squeegee here. Hashtag taco. Oh my gosh, I love it. Every time I'm like, go down like a taco. All right. It's like Taco Tuesday up in here, except for it's Monday. All right, so let's see here. So I've got this little buckle in the D. So let's see if I can attempt to fix it. Yeah, I was able to do that right away. So once you pick that up, sometimes if you leave it alone, you see it's completely gone. Coffee, because adulting is hard. Now, once again, when I welded this, I lost a little bit of my design in my coffee bean, and then I lost my G. But I could go back. I could actually pull this coffee bean off, cut another coffee bean, cut out my G. Like I said, call it a day. So, adulting is just a new slide. That's right, adulting. I'm just adulting today. Coffee is coffee because adulting is hard up in her. Okay, so there you go. Super cute. And that's right, because you know if you've got to have coffee. I already can't speak today. So technically, I'm saying adulting right. Adulting is hard at times. Oh my gosh, I love y'all so much. You guys are just the best. I love hanging out with you guys. Just make it adulting. That's right. I'm going to put the little apostrophe on there, and that's what we're going to do. We're going to call it a day. And another thing is, you know what I've done sometimes? If it's a little apostrophe, I'll take my vinyl here, and y'all tell me if y'all done the same. Say, for example, if I cut an eye and I messed up, I'll actually go in here and I will snip. So this is a little thing to help you guys too, because you could snip this all day long until you get the perfect eye. And I don't have to go back into the thing and cut out another one. I cut this down just a little bit more and we're going to call it a day. So I could probably have made this just a little bit more skinny. And we are going to pop this right in here because you guys made this adult. So cute. And like I said, I could go back. How cute is that? Adorable. I did not even have to go back in there. Is very large coffee cup. So This one right here, I just love it. So you could definitely play around with this. Once again, I could change these colors since they're all broken down. I could change this to pink. I could change these to brown. I could do all sorts of individual colors. Love, love, love it. Thank you guys for saving the coffee cup and allowing me to change it to a Dalton. So cute. So let's go ahead and get our next one. And I think I'm going to go ahead and do this so you guys can look at them at the same time. So bear with me while I prop these guys up so y'all can see them while we work, because we are almost done. Bringing my scissors here, just like that. So make sure you guys are using the hashtag #bundle today to win for a chance to win this bundle, because we are almost done. Also, if you guys have any questions, we are going to answer those. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and go down. Now, once again, if you guys are a Plus member, make sure you guys are snagging your 6 free files every single day up until December 31st, because we are doing that Christmas event for you Plus members. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and rub this down. Now, this would be so cute as a card decal. This would be so cute for a t-shirt. Absolutely love this. This would also be really cute to sublimate on the back of a phone case. So just rub everything down. Going to flip it over. Great idea. So, so cute. Here we go. All right, so here we go. So here's our awesome design. Be the person your dog thinks you are. I absolutely love this file here. So, so cute. I don't have a conversation with humans until I finish my first cup of coffee. Amen. I'm same here. It's like, back it up. Let me get that coffee in and then we'll chat. So let's set this guy aside if we don't accidentally mess it up before we get there. So we are going to rub down our last cup. Once again, spray on this. I've been using this exact same one for the last probably 6 years, I feel like. It's been a long time, 6, 7 years. I just refill my alcohol, same spritzer. It's amazing. I highly recommend Tim Holtz Distress Sprayer. Say that 10 times fast. Works so, so good. Once again, Amazon, we may try to link this down below afterwards for you guys. Highly recommend, because you know how sometimes those sprayers just get gunked or go bad? This dude has lasted me years, and it's just perfect for projects like this to keep your alcohol in there. So I love the Plus event. Got some great files. I'm telling you, 6 files every day, Jessica. I bet you're loving it. And then the free fonts. We've got fonts. We've got stuff for our planners. We've got SVGs. Lots of different things. All right. Also, I got myself a planner. So you guys be prepared. We're going to be making some planner stuff this year. So stay tuned for 2022. All right. So we've got it ready. So this design, she decided to roll over here. I think she's still going to do it. Let's see. We could take a pair of scissors too. I'm like, sit. I don't know why it's trying to. It's okay. I think, yeah, she's just, maybe it's that rubbing alcohol. You guys see that? Slowly just starting to drift down. That's okay. Here we go. So I'm going to, hold on 1 second. I have an idea. I'm going to take my other one. See how I've got it rolled up? And now it's like a double-sided adhesive. I'm going to pop that dude down right in the center. And boom. Now she's not going nowhere. So there's another tip for you guys. All right. So this design here is a little bit different because this one's length was going, horizontal. I never can get horizontal, vertical, right? Anybody else? Nope. She's like, I'm still going somewhere. I don't know why she's doing this. There we go. Got it. Stay. All right. So this one is going to be vertical, I believe, or length. Once again, I'm using my camera. So bear with me to get this straight. Hopefully, fingers crossed, everybody. So I'm going to drop it down. I went down like a taco, hashtag taco. And then we're going to get that center here. And we're going to fold down one side of that taco, take off our adhesive here. And then we're going to fold down the other one here. So absolutely, I love using the squeegee tool. That it just works out perfect. Tumblers, cups, all sorts of different things that you can do with this. Make sure you guys are using hashtag bundles, innovative. I love it. All right, so we're going to go ahead and use this squeegee here to rub it in. So once again, you guys could see, you could go nice and bold. So I went really bold on this. 3.75 high, but you could bring it down even 3 inches and it's still going to look good. But I love coffee mugs like this where it's really nice and bold. Once again, we would let this sit for 48 to 72 hours to let that adhere so that so it can bond with the mug. So we're just going to rub everything in. And once again, that matte, gorgeous. Love it. You guys let me know, hashtag matte or hashtag gloss. What's your favorite? I love matte. Hashtag taco. I love it so much. Be the person that your dog thinks you are. So look at this. three different, I can't wait for the planner projects. I'm so excited, you guys. We've got lots of different stuff coming 2022. I've been doing a lot of stuff in the background, and I'm planning, using that planner to plan. So lots of fun things coming for 2022. Let's see, I do too. Always pause and think. I know I really struggle with horizontal and vertical all the time. I have to really think about it. And you know, as much as we ask ourselves that question, we should have it by now. So you guys can see here, I'm going to bring these back in here so we can see everybody what we've made today. These are three different files, three different ones from that bundle. So each one of these came from a bundle that was within the bundle. So, I mean, absolutely gorgeous. Such a great bundle to snag up for your stash there. Once again, if you guys are not, if you guys haven't used design bundles, if you're new to it, those files, you can download them whenever you want to. You could download them right away. If you forgot, lost the file, had it on another computer, come back, download it again. So it's super, super easy. Hashtag Matt. These are all wonderful, awesome tips. Thank you so much, Lisa. I hope you guys enjoyed this. So let's go ahead and get ready for Q&A. Go ahead and get my coffee cups up here so you guys can hopefully see, and then ignore my mess. I'll try to clean it up here while we get ready for our comments. So bear with me for a second. I'm going to move everything out of our way and make sure you guys can see all of our super cute cups. All right, let's see. What was the brand name of the vinyl you were using, and where do you buy it? All right, so that brand is Starcraft, and I actually buy it in the roll because the Starcraft is so affordable, you're not even going to believe it. I get it from 143 Vinyl. We have linked it down below, but I believe we linked it for the 12x12 sheets, but you can buy them in 12x12, 12x24, but I buy the rolls. They come like this, and I just stack them together, and what's really nice is you can reuse these rolls for lots of different things, and sometimes I even store other materials right inside of here, but it's a huge roll and I get it in white and black because those are my main colors. And then I get other colors in the 12x12 sheets. So Starcraft all the way. And I really love the matte colors. All right, let's see. Is this recorded? Yes, it is. It is recorded. So you can watch this over and over again. Let's see. I love that pin. Where can I purchase it? The pin here is from 143 Vinyl. It is called the Pin Weeding Tool. And I believe if you spend X amount of money with them, you could get these for $5. I do believe there is similar ones on Amazon, but I think we have one linked down below. And if we don't, we will start linking those for you guys because it's amazing. All right, let's see. What would be a good starter printer? If you're just getting into sublimation and you don't want, it's kind of hard because now with the pandemic, the Epson printers have really went up. But if you're just wanting to get in, you could start out with an Epson, like one of the cheaper ones that are like $200. And I'm not sure because there's a lot of different numbers. So I say, for example, I think I have the Epson 2760. I have a couple different ones. And there is Starcraft actually has an ink out in the market. But if you could splurge, highly recommend the Sawgrass SG500 to start with. The tech support that you're going to have with it, all of those things, highly recommend Sawgrass all the way. All right, let's see. I thought I ordered a permanent vinyl and received temp. So can I do the same crafts with it? If you got removable, I would not do coffee, which let me take that back. Removable will become permanent over time. So it's removable for so long, but over time it will become permanent. So if you actually let it set a little longer than the 48 to 72 hours, probably more if you let it set for a couple of weeks. And if you hand wash it, really baby it. But for example, if you bought removable on accident, use them on signs, anything inside, decor, lots of different things, keychains you can steal. I have keychains that I've carried for years with removable and it has not budged a bit. So lots of different things you can still do with removable. And remember, removable will eventually become permanent. Also, I have done car decals with removable and they've not went nowhere. All right, let's see. Hashtag bundles. Is there any vinyl you can bake onto ceramic mugs? Not that I know of. I do believe with the heat that it would start to melt because, say, for example, I talked about this in the last video. I made some signs on metal for Christmas, and we stored them up in our attic, and the heat from our attic actually melted that adhesive on the back. So whenever I pulled them out this year, they were crumbled into one mess in the center. So keep that in mind. All right, let's see. Do you need to seal it? You definitely do not. Once again, you don't want to throw these in the dishwasher. You want to hand wash these. And when we say hand wash, we mean, you know, dip it down into your sink water, wash it out, gently wash this and rinse. Don't just let it soak in your sink and they'll last a very long time if you do them like that. And also for the ceiling, you can use dishwasher safe Mod Podge if you do want to seal them. Where is the scraper from? This one right here, you can actually grab these from Amazon all over. 143 Vinyl has them for $2 and something, but most places you can snag these. I do even believe like Silhouette, this is what theirs looks like, but really check around because these are only $2. So when I order from 143, every time I order, I grab another one or two so I can, I have them all over the place. All right, let's see. Is there any more? Let's see. Are you only able to use the Cricut specifically mugs? No, you can actually use any sort of mug. So any mugs, it can be any sort of mugs, but any sort of sublimation blank you can use in there. They call their mugs, I believe, 12 and 15 ounces, but you can actually, I believe they're 11 ounces in reality through like if you order JPP or Condi or anything like that, Amazon, you could still fit those in there. So you can use any other brand that is made for sublimation. Let's see, can you put permanent vinyl in the dishwasher? I have done the dishwasher test. It has withheld it, but after probably 2 to 3 times, it's going to come off. Now, the first time, if I had real small pieces, I'd probably lose a piece or so, but these big pieces will kind of withhold more than the small ones. But after probably the second or third time, you're going to start to see some stuff come off. All right, let's see. Do you have to mirror your image before? No. With the mugs, you don't need a mirror because you're working with adhesive vinyl. So if it was HTV for the t-shirts, you mirror. But for projects like this, for mugs and signs, you don't need a mirror. Let's see. Have you ever used a vinyl shield? It goes over your vinyl and it is... I have not. I'm going to have to look that up. So I have seen... See, for example, Sparkleberry, she has this really cool stuff. I'm going to show you guys very soon. I think I actually have some in a box over here. It is this glitter. So it's a glitter. So say, for example, right here, the vinyl, adhesive vinyl, it's glitter. And what she's done is, say, for example, your patterns or your solids, you can actually put that over it and it turns it into a glitter. It's really neat. But that probably would help a little bit too, something to look into. But I'm about to look up a vinyl shield. We need to make note of that. Why do you spritz the alcohol again? The only reason why I do this is so that way I don't have an alcohol bottle and I'm having to like pour it on there. It just makes it so quick to spritz it, wipe it. And it just makes it so, so much easier. You don't have to do this. And once again, recently too, I've just been using a dry cloth. I don't even use alcohol every time, but the alcohol is to remove any sort of oils or debris, which will help your adhesive vinyl last a very long time. All right, let's see. I need to get a heat press. Which one should I get? Depending on what you're doing. If you're just doing simple crafts, I would go for the middle Cricut 9x9. That's the one I always recommend for Cricut over all others because it's very versatile. You could do several presses to get a big press. You could do the baby onesie still and all of those things. So I really say Cricut 9x9. But if you were going to get into a bigger heat press, I would go for example, Stahl's A to Z is very affordable. I think it's still like 500, but it's going to last you the rest of time. It's not going to go bad. And it is by far one of the best presses on the market. All right. So I think that was our last question. So let's get ready for the giveaway. Right. So let's get ready. So good luck to everybody. I see we have, I think it says 427 here. So I am so excited. So let's go ahead and hit draw and good luck, guys. So whoever gets this, I hope you guys craft some goodies. Make sure you use that hashtag design bundles live so we can see them. So let's see. Congratulations, Lisa? Pat Edwards. Make sure you guys email, I believe it is mail@designbundles.net for your prize. So all you simply have to do is shoot them an email, let them know that you have won today and you will get your bundle and you can start crafting ASAP. So thank you guys so much for participating with us today. We are so glad that you guys joined us once again. I hope you guys enjoyed this. I hope you guys are going to make yourself some Dollar Tree mugs for this next year. They make the perfect gift. So I hope you guys enjoyed this and I will see you guys on the next one. Bye for now.